Ta-da! Hello, my lovely Facebookers. So I'm going live on my page, which I never do, and I just did it spontaneously today because I'm getting asked lots of questions about how to get started with kettlebells and can I really do this from home and what would you suggest I start with and how do I start? So guess what? I'm going to show you some stuff today that literally you can start with right away. So we are in the studio, and obviously I am surrounded by kettlebells, but really in order for you to do any sort of kettlebell training, specifically for women, I would suggest investing in only two belts. So let me take you, I'll stand up now. Actually, I might put this down just a teeny little bit. Bear with me. There we go. Beautiful. So you're gonna see from here that I have been joined by two beautiful belts, okay? So I always get asked, where do you get your kettlebells from? What kettlebells should I use to start with? Believe it or not, I have done a full blog post on my blog at warriorgoddesskettlebelltraining.com/blog all about getting started with kettlebells, okay? So there's a beginner's guide to kettlebell training there. There's a guide to buying your first kettlebell. There's a guide to the swing, which is what we're gonna do today. So my suggestion is that you start off with an 8 kilo. This one particular one is an 8 kilo. And you also get yourself a second bell, either, I would recommend actually a 6 kilo, which is really good. I don't know what these are in pounds. My American friends, you're gonna have to just kind of work that out for me. So a 6 kilo and an 8 kilo. You wanna try to get them, and I go through this in my guide to buying your first kettlebell. They don't have to be, you know, coated, vinyl coated, or this one's neoprene coated. They don't have to be coated. However, I find that sometimes for grip purposes, it can really help. This one's vinyl coated, okay? So, but the most important thing is that they're not got square handles. You'll also find that I'm not a big fan of stainless steel handles, that I prefer the cast iron. And that's because, again, the grip is easier with stainless steel handles, especially when it's weather like this here in Belfast. It's really hot. You can get really sweaty and it feels really slippy. And you don't want square handles because they're really hard to rack, which is not something we're going to teach today, but it can make it even more awkward on the wrists. So these are my recommended ones. So I will pop underneath this video today, information of how to guide buying your first kettlebell. It also teaches you in the Ultimate Guide of Beginners how to hold the bell in different grips and how to get started, so you can go and watch those videos. But today I really just wanted to take you through a really short, easy beginner's workout. Now this is like a beginner's workout, so maybe you have lifted a bell before, but maybe you've seen a bell before, maybe you've seen me swing a kettlebell before, maybe you want to introduce some kettlebell training at home but you don't know which ones you want to do, then this is what we're going to do today. So I'm only going to teach you two moves, but we're going to put it into a kettlebell workout, and I'm also going to give you different progressions of that kettlebell workout. And this is what I love about kettlebell training, because confession time, I am the laziest healthy person that I know. I don't necessarily enjoy exercise. If it wasn't for the fact that I became a fitness professional and set up a studio, I would definitely not exercise pretty much every day. But what I've found about kettlebells is, even if you have complete ADHD like me, if you get bored easily, if you're not somebody who enjoys exercise, if you're not somebody who likes the gym, then you can get all the benefits of strength training, all the benefits of lifting or weight lifting, in addition to a HIIT or a high intensity workout. Plus you're gonna get all the extra bonus from the fat blasting and also for your joints, etc. This is why we like the kettlebell. It's also fast, it's also really efficient. And if you get bored, you can just change it up. You can add something else. You can think about a new move. In my opinion, it's kind of foolproof, and I'd be the biggest fool for exercise. So this is why we love it. So shall I stop talking now about how much I love kettlebells and just get started? So this particular workout is called the swing and halo. Guess which two moves we're going to be doing? Yep, the swing and the halo. So I'm going to take you through a kettlebell swing. I'm going to take you through a halo, okay? Two moves. This is one of the 5 beginner workouts that I have as a free download, which I'm also going to pop under this video, that you can download with me doing more videos like this in your living room. It's a workout that could be 10 minutes or it could be 20 minutes, depending on how many rounds you do. And that's what I like about kettlebell training, is there's always a next level for you to try to go to. So shall we get started? So this one is going to be with the 8 kilo kettlebell. So I'm going to grab my 6 kilo with my feet either side, and I'm going to move it out of the way. I'm going to put that there, and then I'm going to make sure you guys can see it. So I'm going to move it back just a teeny bit. There, you can see it now, okay. So we're going to start with the kettlebell swing. So I'm going to show you the kettlebell swing first and foremost so you can see it. Then I'm going to break it down into the three kind of stages of the kettlebell swing. And then we're just going to do some kettlebell swinging, okay? So, first of all, let me demonstrate it for you. In our online programs, it would be something that you would do, takes the length of a pop song, but I have done that before I've started training, and you should too. That was the kettlebell swing. So normally when people see the kettlebell swing for the first time, they generally have two responses. The first one is, holy good lord, you want me to do that? That looks really weird. Just that look, like this. So just a bit taken aback, deer in the headlights. Because it does look a bit intensive, it does look a bit kind of scary. There's a bit where you're kind of on the ground, and there's a bit when you're up here. You think it's got something to do with the arms, but you're not sure, but maybe it's got something to do with the butt. You've heard it's really good for the butt, so maybe it's got something to do with that. So let me tell you, the reason why we love the kettlebell swing is that it's the answer to all of your problems. Basically, normally when ladies come in here, they fill out little questionnaires, they normally say, that they're normally ticking things about maybe ailments or conditions or issues that they have with their body. One in two females who come through this door tick lower back pain, okay? And the reason why we have lower back pain is because we're using our back too much to lift things, to get up and down, to move. Rather, and we tend to hang out in our front body, crumpled over, texting, all those sorts of things, and we don't use our back body, which is known as our posterior chain, so everything from our heels all the way up to our head, and we don't use those. So, and what I need you to do is to think about using the back body. So the key to this is activating your glutes. So, it's really interesting because I've realized that my job in life is to teach people to squeeze their butt cheeks. Yep, I teach people to thrust and to squeeze most days. So, in fact, I think I say squeeze your butt cheeks, I don't know, maybe a good 100 times a day, because that's why it's so important. Now, here's the thing. This muscle, which we call our glutes, we've got our gluteus maximus, we've got our medius on the outside, there's other little muscles in there, but the butt cheek area, and I call them butt cheeks, because who goes around and says, my glutes? Nobody really says that, unless they're maybe a fitness professional working on their glutes. But generally, there's so much going on here that we just don't use. In fact, we have not only are we sitting on them every day, we've been sitting on it for the last 10, 20, 30 years. So even if it was an easy to activate muscle, which it's not, you're going to have difficulty dealing with trying to activate the glutes. So this kettlebell swing and teaching the kettlebell swing in this way, it's really important to understand that you might not get it first time. It's something that you're going to have to work towards. And what I really like about that is that, especially somebody for me, you know, a wee bit attention deficit, oh, look, bright, shiny things. This is really good because my attention is caught because I'm too busy thinking about how good can I do this and did I squeeze and did I do this and what about my knees and all of that sort of stuff. So we're going to activate our glutes. So this is the biggest muscle group. It is also one of our most powerful muscle groups. For females, we are stronger in this area, almost 10 times stronger pound for pound down in this area than men, who's more up here, is their powerhouse. This is our powerhouse in terms of our hips and our glutes and our posterior chain. However, we're fighting, you know, history and genetics. If you're somebody who already leads a sedentary life, sitting down a lot, you're going to spend a lot of time trying to learn how to activate. So we're going to teach you how to activate your glutes. Which is basically how to squeeze your butt cheeks and how to use your bum muscles. And guess what the benefit of that is? There's so many benefits. First of all, if you're somebody with lower back pain, you can basically learn to kettlebell swing your pain away. In fact, I've had clients come in through here who've had bolus discs or disc spinal disc issues, who within a matter of weeks have actually been able to strengthen both their core and their glutes enough for them to alleviate a lot of their back pain. I've had actually quite a few clients within a matter of weeks finding that that is the case. Ladies who've been with me for a long period of time say that they never get back pain at all, ever. And it's not something that I get. If anything, I would get a little bit of hip pain, but it's normally from when I start to squat heavy using barbells and dumbbells and not when I'm working with kettlebells. The other thing I wanted to say was that it's going to help you to alleviate that, but it's also about lifting the butt cheeks up. Because who doesn't want a prettier booty, right? You want a juicy, beachy boot. Juicy, beachy, but you know what I'm trying to say. This is going to help to lift things up in that general direction and also help to add a curve, a little bit more jump in the trunk. So for my flat-bottomed ladies, you can come from a flat bottoms to curvy peaches with just a swing of the belt on a regular basis. So let me teach you the three main steps of the kettlebell swing. So you'll know there that I came down on the bell in a hinge, okay? So this is what we call a hinge. It's not a squat, it's a hinge, okay? And it's quite an intense hinge in so much as that I'm almost horizontal with my hinge. Now as I hinge, automatically, unless you're a yogi and you're doing a forward fold, which is not what this is, when you hinge, your job is to stick your bottom out as far out the other direction to your head. That's the goal here. You're trying to make your bum go as far that way as you can. Also, when you do that, you will naturally add a little bend in your knee. It's not a completely straight leg forward fold. There is a natural bend. And how you know when to stop is when you start to feel the fire behind your knees, start to feel the start of the stretch, basically, a little bit of fire behind the knees. Okay? So that's how I know I'm sticking my bum out as far as I can and my shoulders are down, like I'm pecking the floor. I'm generally looking down on the ground as well. And that will help you. Sometimes looking up a little bit will help you later on, but that's the hinge. Then the second part is the thrust. So as you come up, a kettlebell swing is what we call a ballistic motion, and ballistic from the concept of guns, something being fired very quickly. So a ballistic motion starts in this instance starts in your hips. So basically what I want you to do in the world is to give it both barrels, okay? So you're shooting out from both barrels and from the hips, basically, okay? So you're a gunslinger shooting out from both hips. So it's quite an intensive, quite a ballistic or an explosive move, okay? So as you do that, it should feel quite intense, quite fierce. And the final one is the squeeze. So we've got the hinge, the thrust, and the squeeze. That's the squeeze. So that is you learning to activate your glutes. You're following through with the last of the thrust, with the last of the squeeze. Now, if you do that correctly, you should, first of all, completely straighten or have full extension on your hip flexors. Your hip flexors are here. So as you come forward, you're squeezing and your hip flexors are extended. You also should do a little bit of a snap. So as you come up, you snap. So your knees become locked because that's what happens when you stand tall. Okay? You squeeze your bum. You can't help but squeeze your quads too because it kind of comes as a package. In fact, you end up squeezing a lot of other stuff too. You know, like your toilet muscles and all those other things. Ladies, you'll be pleased to know, especially mums and new mums, all of that gets pulled up with your squeeze. And then as you're squeezing, you can't help but do like a little snap. If you're doing it efficiently and correctly, there is a little snap. So this little motion is quite explosive. It's the snap that acts as the brakes of the bell, which we're going to talk about in a second. But also, if you do this correctly, you should jiggle a little. Yes, ladies, you should jiggle. This is how why I love training ladies only, is because I can say to them that you're going to jiggle. It might not be the place you want to jiggle, because I can't control the jiggle, but you're gonna get a bit of the jiggle, okay? And then the last thing I'm going to teach while I'm on the bell. But basically, that's the hinge, thrust, and squeeze. Hinge, thrust, and squeeze. Very important that you do lock out the knee, because that's what you do when you stand up. And that's what helps you to get the break and that last bit of squeeze. You cannot efficiently squeeze without squeezing your quads, which actually locks out the knee, and that's really important. So let me just teach the last little bit, which is tilting the bell towards you. So what you're going to basically do is tilt the bell towards you, and in this way, you need to learn to flatten your back or activate your lats, or lots of different cues I can give you at this point. But the most important one is that you activate your lats. So look, round back, flat back, okay? Round back, flat back. So I'm loading my heels, I'm not hanging out on my toes, I'm loading my heels, I flatten my back, which means I kind of squeeze my my two shoulder blades together, trying to stick my boobs out a little bit. I've looked up, maybe a mat or a square ahead of me, and I'm ready to go. Now as I pull this bell back, it's gonna feel for the first time quite heavy, and it might feel quite scary, but your job is to ping it straight back out again like a pinball machine, okay? So as we pull this behind us, you then ping it straight back out. Not using your arms in any way. Here we go, so we pull it back. Hinge thrust squeeze. Hinge thrust squeeze. Now the breath happens as you thrust and squeeze. Now that's a little high because this is quite light for me. I'm going to stop now. And you just put it down the way that you start. You can hear how cardio it is because I'm going to be out of breath. I'm just checking. I think I got a comment there. Oh, we've lost me. Oh no. Well, I hope you can see me again. I'm not sure if the connection is good. But that's the hinge, thrust, squeeze. That is the kettlebell swing. So it's the hinge, the thrust, the squeeze, the flat back, pull it out so that the arms are touching the inside of your thighs, okay? You do not use your arms. Mine went a little bit high because that is quite a light bell for me. Normally I swing with at least 12 or my 10 that I work with, or my 9. So that one's quite light. So it shouldn't really come any higher than your chest level. Normally, if it's a heavier bell, it wouldn't even make it that far because you're literally just pinging it out. The arms are just the pendulum. They're just there to hold on to the bell. And then your job is not only is it thrusting and squeezing it out, but it's the eccentric motion of bringing the bell back with you taking your hinge down and your bum down that's going to allow you to not only slow the bell down, because that's very fast and heavy and gravity and all that, and then ping it straight back out again. Let me just see. So can you let me know if you are... Andy, I see that you said that we've lost you. Is there anybody else there? Oh, I've got a little wave. Hi. So who's on? Colette's on. Andy's on. Ellie Ria's on. I don't know. Could somebody write me a little comment and let me know if you're still getting the signal okay? I can see a couple of people saying live, but you just never know how many's actually on. So that was the kettlebell swing. So that's one of the two moves I'm going to show you today. And then the second one is using the smaller of the two bells. So I'm going to take my feet either side, as always, pick it up with a flat back and bring it to myself. So, let me see. Somebody's setting the wrong motion. Karen's giving me a thumbs up. That means you can actually do it. That's good. Perfect. So this other one is basically, you can hear I'm still out of breath from just those 5 swings. Wait till we start doing the circuits. You're going to love it. So this is a different hold for this particular move. This is called the halo. There's a couple of different ways to do this halo. I like to do it this way, which I'm going to teach you. So you want to grab the bell bottoms up, okay? Bottoms up, or this is also called goblet. Now, when it's a smaller bell like this, you can put your hands around it, whatever way feels more comfortable. Some people like to have little safety fingers in there. Some people just like to hold it by the horns, whatever works for you. So this would be a goblet hold in your rack. So in life, this is your rack. In kettlebells, this is also your rack. In fact, that's where the term came from. Nice rack. Why, thank you. That's exactly where it came from. So you want to hold it in your rack, and as you hold it in your rack, you're going to notice that activates my triceps. So my triceps and my arms are activated just holding this in the rack. So the move we're going to do, I would suggest doing it at the beginning with a slightly lighter bell, like this one, which is a 6, but you can easily do it with a heavier bell. And then you want to take that in front of you, okay? So it's almost like your wrists are slightly out. Can you see that? So I'm not holding it like this. I'm holding it bottoms up with my wrists slightly out. And then what you want to do is just take the bell around your head. Yeah, it is true. Let me show you, okay? So you're going to go round the back, and then a wee swing here to make the no-shows. So some like to do a little, just a little smaller halo like this. But I like, specifically for ladies, like to take it really wide and really deep. And the reason why is that, look how far that tape goes down my back. And it stretches out my back and stretches out my triceps. I also have to engage my core to get this to work. And it feels really good because I can really feel my core working, my triceps working. I can use a little swing to get a bit of momentum. And I'm using a lot of my upper body. So my obliques, which is my side waist, my core is being worked, my triceps, which are the backs of my arms, my chest. Oh, I feel like everything's working. And this is actually something that we would do as part of our warm-up for our strong classes and for our strong warm-up, which is all about the upper body. And I'm going to do one more just so you can see. And you should be messing up your hair. It shouldn't be that close to the head that you're messing up your hair. So that is the halo, which is nice and easy. You will learn to love the halo. It's definitely something that we do on a regular basis, and I love personally because I can feel that opening up my chest, I can feel it opening up the tops of my shoulders. If you're a lady who's larger chested, like myself, we tend to get really tight across here, so this can help you feel open and can help to strengthen the upper back as well as the lower back, because it's important to do the kettlebell swing for a nice strong glutes, which will help take the pressure off the lower back, but that one helps to open up our shoulders, our upper back, and our chest as well. So the workout that we're going to do, and I'm not going to do all of it, I'm already out of breath, I have to teach class in half an hour, but this is the swing and halo. We're going to do 10 swings, 4 halos, okay? And we're just going to keep going with that until we feel like we need to take a break. The goal is to make it to 10 sets, but you can choose to have a break at any time, you can choose to have a drink at any time. That's not what it's about. For you, it's about just starting to feel the intensity of the workout itself, starting to feel your heart rate coming up, starting to being okay with the intense style of workout that the kettlebell can help you to get, but also I promise you, you will feel super duper pumped, super duper energetic, super duper excited and motivated and focused. It's one of those things that because the blood's pumping through and you're breathing and you're doing all these things, you just feel epic and awesome. So just those two moves alone can almost give you a full body. It's not quite a full body workout. You would need to add a press in there, but it's a beginner's workout, so I'm not going to throw a push-up or a press-up in there because that would just be plain old me. So I'm going to do this now. I'm going to do maybe a couple. We'll see how we go. And you can maybe watch this video later. You can watch the replay. You can do it with me if you haven't got bells now. You can use this as a follow-along at some point. But this is one of the 5 workouts in my Never Bell workouts, as we call them. So never touch the bell workout. It's the very first one. It's the swing and halo. There's 5 lovely workouts in there. We've also just added a 30-day challenge where I'm teaching you those different 5 workouts and when to have them and when to do them and when to rest. So that by the end of 30 days, you will have built yourself up to be able to do something almost every day of the week, which is wonderful for kettlebells because it's never any length of time. I mean, this is going to take you 10 minutes, maybe 12 minutes of a workout. Perfect. That is all you need. So I'm going to stop talking now. I'm going to get swinging. So I'm moving my smaller bell here, and then I'm just going to get started. So I'm going to do 10, then I'm going to do 4. I'm just going to keep going until I'm out of breath or I need a drink. Are you with me? Here we go. Make sure you load the heels, flatten the back, use the breath. Go. 1, 2. Put it down the way you started. Come over, pick up the goblet style, put it down, and 4. 1, 2, 3, 4, and here we go. helps you to get your breathing back on track, because the kettlebell swing can be so intensive. Here we go. Flatten back, load those heels. Beautiful. We'll do one more. You should be messing up the hair. Take it as far back as you can. A wee swing is fine. And let's end it there. That was four, maybe five. Definitely out of breath. I would definitely be taking a drink right now. But you can see how easy it is to get a full workout. All you need is two kettlebells. Look how I'm out of breath. I'm really out of breath. Two kettlebells to start off with. In terms of investment in pounds, this would be about less than 30 pounds, but you can use this piece of kit and it's really easy to store. You can do this easily in your living room. You saw that I used no bigger than a yoga mat size to work out. Two pieces of kit can give you almost a full body, but we can work you up to a full body. You can hear that it's cardiovascular, it's getting me fit. You'll know that it's working on strengthening the booty, so therefore taking pressure off the lower back, activating the posterior chain and the core. It's a lot of core work in here. The halos were really good for opening up the upper body and working that, and it's a really good super beginner easy peasy workout that you can build up to 10 rounds really easily and do no more than what, 13 minutes. That was only 5 minutes or 6 minutes, and I got 4 or 5 rounds in. So I would say probably 12 minutes of exercise would be 10 rounds. You might not be able to do it the first time, but you can definitely work your way up to that. And that's what I love about that. So I'm gonna go ahead underneath this video. I'm gonna plop in where you can download those free kettlebell workouts. I'm also gonna plop in a beginner's guide to kettlebell training in there, which has everything. You can also access the swing, well, I've gone through it today, but I go into it even in more depth in that blog post. And if you want to really start this, if you want to think about body shape change, if you really want to be like, okay, I've got this, these kettlebell things, they're not so scary, I could totally do this from home, then it is really the best thing for you to do is to not just think of the workouts, but think of an overall program. And that's what my 28-day Warrior Goddess Body Program is. It's a home-based workout with kettlebells working up to 3 times a week. You will also see that there is the nutrition, meal plans, everything that goes along with it. And you literally get an email every day saying, eat this, do this, eat this, do this, eat this, do this, for 28 days. Guaranteed results. The last couple of testimonials I've just received, somebody just lost 11 pounds in those 28 days. And I've now gone on to do the Wheel of the Year program too, because she really loves the changes that are happening in her body. So if you have any questions about any of this, if you want to reach out and actually talk to me, you can go ahead and message the page. I would love to hear from you. And I see people are coming on board. You can go ahead and re-watch this video. I will pop those links in below. But reach out if you need me for anything. If you are local to the studio here in Belfast, we're having an open day here on June the 9th from 11:30. Free kettlebell classes, free nutrition classes, free kick-ass and free yoga shred classes as well for you to try. Places are almost full. I think there's like one or two in each of the things, so make sure to grab those now and bring your friends. And I look forward to coming and swinging with you on that at that time. So I better go now because we've got classes starting, I have clients coming soon. But again, reach out if you need anything, and whatever you're doing on this gloriously sunny day, have a great one. Peace out.